So, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon and welcome to the Cafe Royal here in central London. This is to officially announce Thunderbolt in Monaco, where, of course, the main event scheduled for 12 three-minute rounds of boxing is for the WBA Super World Middleweight title fight between Martin Murray and Gennady Golovkin, scheduled for 12 three-minute rounds of boxing. It will take place in Monaco at the Salle de l'Étoile on Saturday, the 21st of February, 2015. I'd like you to welcome to the top table the challenger for the WBA Super World Middleweight title fight from St. Helens. Ladies and gentlemen, you please welcome to the top table, Martin Murray. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the reigning WBA Super World Middleweight Champion, the undefeated Gennady Golovkin! Welcome to the UK, welcome to London. It's great to see you here. And how much are you looking forward to the fight with Martin on the 21st of February?
Yes, of course. Good afternoon, everybody. Yes, of course, I'm very happy. You know, just I have a big fight with Martin. I respect him, he's a great champion, he's a great fighter. You know, I promise. Great show, because we have a lot of time for February 21st, you know, just welcome to Monaco. And Roman's great show.
You're in now for being a big hitter, your last two fights, round two, round three, the last 18 inside the distance. Martin has never been stopped.
Absolutely correct, you know, just, I think before just not the same class for me, you know, just I saw a lot of fights with Martin. Martin's fights, he's a strong guy. You know, I think big decision fight, I don't know. Who win, I don't know.
Your last two fights, Daniel Gill, Marco Antonio Rubio, do you think Martin poses a bigger threat than those previous two opponents?
Yeah, I think Martin, he is biggest, more biggest.
What do you think Martin's biggest strength is?
Oh, power, size, you know, just different style, more class, just boxing class.
Martin, third time at a world title fight. Is it going to be third time lucky?
Hello everyone, thanks for coming. Third time fighting in a world title. Just want to say it's great to be back fighting in big fights against elite fighters like Golovkin. You know, as we all know, he's a great fighter. And it's going to be a tough fight for me, but I'm looking forward to the challenge. It's like I said, it's a tough fight, but with it comes a great opportunity for me. And you know, I'm going to take it with both hands. I'm really looking forward to the fight. And you know, I think going back to what you asked Golovkin then about his previous two opponents with Daniel Gill and Rubio, I think that they went in half beat, and I think. You know, they was already beat before again, whereas me, you know, I want the fight, I'm ready for the fight, and I'm coming in there wanting to win, so I am confident that I'm going to win. You know, like, Gennady's a great fighter, we all know that, like I've just said, he's a great fighter and he possesses extreme power, but I think on my day I've got the tools to beat any middleweight in the world, so I'm, you know, quietly confident going into the fight on February 21st.
He's a big hitter. What's your biggest fear of Gennady?
I've got no fears about him, to be honest. Yeah, like you said, he's a big hitter. We all know that, and he just possesses something that me other opponents have never possessed with a knockout power. You know, I fought some fighters with good power, but not with Golovkin. So it's a new challenge for me, a new test, but leg improved in any fight that I've been in before. You know, I deal with the situation, and I think my versatility is going to win me this fight.
You're both in your early 30s as well now. Do you think you're at the peak of your career now, Martin?
Yeah, I'm just getting into it. Maybe if things had gone well after the Stern fight and after the Martinez fight, where I'd have been a lot more busy, maybe I could have been, you know, into my peak a bit earlier, but my career stagnated. And, you know, thanks to Rodney Burnham with Golden Gloves, Mike Whitstock, and me agent, Sir Andrew McCann, my career's got back on track. And I'm going into this fight in good form, and I really do feel like I've just getting into my prime. I'm just going to train hard, obviously, just as I know Golovkin will be. You know, it's a big test for me, but like you said, it's a big test for him as well. And, you know, it's the two best middleweights in the world fighting each other, and thanks to McKennessy, it's live on Channel 5, and, you know, it's going to be a great show and a great fight.
Gennady, will you do anything different in your preparation for this fight, looking at Martin, or do you just take every fight as it comes?
Absolutely. Every time different, because of different style, different size, different boxing class. You know, every time different. You know, I think this step, the biggest step for me. You know, I'm talking with my coach. He have plan. I don't have plan right now. You know, I have weekends. Just great meeting. I go to Big Bear to my training camp. I promise hard work every day, 100%.
And you think that Martin Murray is going to be the hardest fight of your life?
Yeah, right now, yes.
Between 9 and 10 o'clock at the minute. So thanks very much, everybody, for joining us this afternoon. And we wish Martin and Gennady a safe trip into the ring on February the 21st.
To be honest, you know, I mean, you always train hard, you know, you always do that. Ask anyone who we train with, you know, never cut corners. I train like an absolute beast, you know, I always train as best as I can. But regardless of what fight it is, but what you find with big fights like this and world title fights, and especially when you're fighting someone who no one gives you a chance against, I've experienced it twice before with Sturman Martinez, there's just an all different feel to it. And, you know, you just enjoy your training more. Do you know what I mean? Training's always hard. Maybe this will be, you know, Oliver's put me in the loop that it's going to be extra hard, which isn't good, but it is, because I know that come fight night I'll be ready.
Most definitely, and to be honest, we expect nothing else, because you've been into the lion's den twice before. You've been so, probably the unluckiest man I know, you know, in the ring. Yeah. You know, what was it, you went in and you fought Sergio Martinez on the evil Falklands War.
Yeah.
You know, you don't get...
No, it was just an opportunity for me, just like this. And, you know, that was a dangerous fight. And this is a dangerous fight, a tough fight. But, you know, with it comes great opportunity, and why not take it? You know, it's pointless me just coming around beating people I know I can beat. I need a challenge. And, you know, I need someone who can really raise my game for. See you later, Paul. See you later, mate. So yeah, nice one. Yeah, but I need this fight just to raise my game, and that's what I'm gonna do, and that's what I have to do to get the job done.
You've openly said in the past you believe fighters like winning their beat before they throw a punch. You don't strike me as having that fear, Martin, and you've openly said that you haven't.
No, I mean, you know, what can people tell me about Golovkin? He's knocked his last 18 out, I know that. He hits hard. It obviously does. You know, anything people can tell me, that I know it. I know it's a tough fight. But, you know, like I said, it's a great chance for me, and the fact that no one's given me a chance once again. It's motivated me. And to be brutally honest with you, it doesn't matter to me about going. Anybody who knows me from Alden from the past, and I'm not proud to say this, but it doesn't bother me fighting just one lad. Do you know what I mean? In a ring with a referee with gloves on, it doesn't bother me. So it's a tough fight, and it's an hard fight, but I'm just really looking forward to the challenge.
Excellent. And as far as your preparations for this fight with Martin Murray, you've already expressed that you think he's the fight for you at this moment. Your preparations with Abel Sanchez, would they step up?
Yeah. Absolutely. You know, just because Martin, he's best opponent for me right now. And every fight, every performance is different for me. I go with my coach, you know, he tell me again, welcome to my training camp. I have plan, big plan. I have a lot of work, hard work every day, you know, just next week, not next week. This weekend I'm going to California.
To Big Bear?
Yeah.
And you're locked away until the fight in Gennady?
No, just first to California, to Mexico, to Vegas, just a couple press conference.
Martin, as you are fully aware, will not come into this fight to lay down, like maybe others have in the past.
Yes, of course. No, every fighter different. No, different style. Different speed, different tactics. No, of course, yes.
In terms of previous performances, Gennady, what percentage have you been fighting at?
No, I think this time it's more, because I think this time I'm a decision fight. Last couple fights, I have just 2-3 rounds, it's nothing, you know. I hope so. I'll show you.
We'll be right back. Martin Murray will be making his way up to the sky. Let's give up both our fighters big respect. Martin Murray and Gennady Golovkin, the WBA and IBO and WBC interim world champion, will be defending that middleweight championship against the brilliant Martin Murray.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs, bonsoir. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the official weigh-in for the Thunderbolt, the big fight tomorrow night at Salle des Etoiles, Monaco. First up onto the scales at this time will be the challenger, but he is a champion in his own right as he holds the WBC silver medal. From St. Helens,
it's a bummer.
Just in the way in between Mike and Murray and Gennady Golovkin, do you draw anything from that at all?
Nah, both look in good shape, they both look ready. Murray was a bit late getting here, maybe had a bit tight making the weight, that's the only thing I can say. But nah, they look, both look ready, good fight on our hands.
You obviously a keen spectator at ringside tomorrow, currently holding the WBO middleweight title. What's your prediction for tomorrow night's fight?
It depends on how Martin fights him. You know what Golovkin's going to do. He's going to come out and go to work. And he's not the fastest start in the world, Golovkin, but he builds up. When each round, he grows with intensity, you know? So I think it's important for Martin to go out there and establish himself early, get some respect one way or the other. Maybe it's being rough in there or leading off or starting fast, but he's got to get respect. I don't see him being able to box Golovkin, so that's just my opinion.
Yeah,
I'm sure he's got a good plan.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's ready. But I think it's going to be a hard fight. I favour Golovkin to win the fight, just naturally, and might be the favourite. But Martin's in there, he's big, he's strong, he's tough, and he's in there, you know.
You've been around some top trainers in your time, man. You know, the late great Emmanuel Stewart, now Mr. Adam Booth. Obviously you can't give too much away because this might be the fight for you one day soon, but we've seen Daniel Gill try and cut Golovkin off and trade with you. We've seen Macklin try and stand off and give a little bit of ground. What works against Golovkin?
I think you gotta fight him. I mean, you gotta, like, if I was to fight him, I'd make a 4 or 5 round fight and just train for that. Yeah. And go out there and blast.
Flow bombs, ain't
you? Yeah. Because to try and out boxing for 12 rounds, it's a long, long, long time. But that could be done too with the right type of athletic fighter. But I know me and I know my mindset. If I was going in there with him, I'd just go and see what happened and let it all hang out. And make it a 50-50 fight. Whoever lands first will win the winner.
Martin Murray's just weighed in for the biggest fight of his life. You know him as a friend, you've been out in South Africa training with him. How do you think he's coping with his pressure, Rob?
No, I think, you know, he's coping well with the pressure. You know, he's thriving off the really. He's looking in good shape, he's trained hard, he's out well, you know. He's come here now today and he's seen the Barmy Army, the fans. I think he's just given more of a lift, you know, the support he's got here. But everything's gone well for the last 12 weeks of camp. It's gone great, and the last 2 weeks it's been on fire. You know, we can say every camp is the best camp I've ever had, but he knows it's a big fight, he knows the task ahead, and he's completely switched on. As he says, he's took himself away from his family and everyone, and his kids and his wife. He took himself to South Africa, you know, high altitude, you know, nothing to do for us. You know what I mean? We trained, we sat back in our hotel room, you know, not with each other, just on our own. Back out training 3 times a day, heat, high altitude. And I think he's really switched on. He really is switched on. Everything's got the plan, the tactics he's been working on with Oliver's gone spot on. And he's just got a show Saturday night. He's got a show Saturday night. All that work he's put in, he's got to pay off on Saturday for.
You were marked up a little bit. Did he hurt you at all?
No, it's okay. Just no, I don't think.
You're going to fight quite soon, apparently. April, you think you were fighting again?
Wait,
May. Where's it going to be, in America?
I hope so.
Do you know an opponent?
No. But if quarter is ready to go, we can move our date to June. It's no problem.
Take a holiday.
Thank you.
Bernardi, how big would you describe Martin Murray's heart, his fighting heart? When many opponents would have quit, he carried on, he kept coming.
Yes, of course. You know, after two knocking down, after four rounds, just I feel this fight is controlled with me. You know, he's not stopped. You know, he's moved, he won't fight. You know, okay, maybe a last round for him, just he can't. I see he can't, you know, just. He's a great fighter. I think so now because you know he's smart. He's smart, more experienced for us. You know, after four rounds, he's very close. You know, he has a lot of moves. Just okay, he's not open fight. You know, not like street fight. Now just very smart guy. He cannot a lot of moves. Just I'm staying here. Let's go. I need fight. You know, just show me. He's you know very close fight. Because you know after four rounds, and he a little bit open, I beat him. And after four rounds, he's close. Of course, this is the biggest fight for me right now because now Miguel is regular champion. No, any unification fight.
How soon do you want to be back in Ireland?
Next week.
Next week?
Next week. Thank you.
I'm obviously disappointed. Put a lot into this camber. Come to the mall, you know what I mean? He was a very good fighter, very strong. And I give it my all, and it won't good enough, unfortunately. But you know, there's not much more I can do, really.
How'd you feel in yourself after that?
A bit gutted.
Physically.
Yeah, feel good. Yeah, feel good. Obviously, never been down before, so that was another experience to me. But it was. Yeah.
What does that feel like first time? Disappointment, perhaps.
No, it's just obviously there's a feeling of just obviously it's a new experience and just getting round it, like you know. But no, I managed to get over the first couple of knockdowns and the third as well. But he was just too strong. I couldn't keep him off him. Mm. I couldn't keep him off me. You know what I mean? He was a good fighter, mate.
He's a great fighter.
Because there were a lot of times in rounds when you had a really good sort of 2 minutes,
yeah,
and then it'd sort of catch you, and it's sort of almost like you'd almost see the sort of strength draining from you at times.
Yeah.
Is that how it felt in there?
No, it does. I just couldn't keep him off, you know. And even though I'd hit him, like I'd hit him with a couple of good shots, and you know, kind of get his attention. He was still there. You know, he was throwing big shots, and he'd occasionally catch me, and I'm, you know, you just obviously start thinking. Then you know, I've got to be careful. I can't throw the shots I want to throw because he's going to end up catching me one of these and putting me out. You know what I mean? So it was. Yeah, it was a tough fight. I mean, it was great being in there, being with someone that calibre. Definitely the best person I've fought. But I come to them more. You know, I've took myself away from my family. I've had a hard 12-week training camp. I've done everything possible to win this fight. And I couldn't do more. I couldn't do them more. So.
But with that performance, I mean, a lot of people say that performance would probably beat any other middleweight in the world, that performance you just put on there.
I don't know. I've got to obviously look back. It's different. Being in there and then watching it when you know after the fight, so I've got to watch that myself. But I believe him. My thing tonight was proving I was the best middleweight in the world. Obviously that's not happened. I do believe I'm the second best middleweight in the world, but I've still not got a belt. Do you know what I mean? And that's what I want. So yeah, I'm just gonna have a rest now for a couple of weeks and see where I go from here.
And your thoughts about what? Because obviously that's your last fight with the current deal with Rodney, isn't it? Here.
No, we've just signed another hand, have we?
Have
we?
We're just sorting another now. Yeah. So.
But you're thinking that's the way to go? Because I mean, you're looking maybe Andy Leaves based out here.
Yeah, well there you go. Yeah, that'd be a great fight. I know he's obviously got Quillen first. It'd be a good fight. I always want the big domestic fights. And the fact that Andy's got a world title as well, you know, it'd be brilliant. But that's definitely a fight I'm looking for.
Do you take a lot of pride in the fact that you've survived longer than anyone else has?
Not really. I got beaten, obviously I'm gutted, so
Do you think in time you may reflect and take some pride?
Possibly. But at the minute, obviously, I'm gutted, and you know, I can't think about anything other than I've been beat. So.
No thoughts of stopping, right? I mean, you're still full of running, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah. I mean, that's the first war I've been in, really. Do you know what I mean? I've had 32 fights now, I think, and 32 is the first war I've been in, so there's plenty of them left in me, and there's plenty of years left in me yet, so, you know, I've just got to see where I can go, opportunities middleweight-wise. But there's obviously the possibility of stepping up, but I've just got to wait and see what's there for me in middleweight. I'd love a big fight with Andy Lee. Obviously, I'm hoping he gets through the quilling fights, and just see where we go from here.
Yeah, you mentioned super middleweight there. Have you got your eye on a fight? I mean, Alfred Abraham would be very beatable, wouldn't he?
After watching him, his first fight with Smega, I believe he beat Paul tonight, which I'm obviously Paul's a good lad and I'm gutted for him, so sorry to hear that when I got back to changing rooms. But I've not obviously planned on going up. These are just possibilities. I think, and me and Oliver think, that I'll be a better super middleweight than I would a middleweight. Do you know what I mean? But my opportunity has been a middleweight for the time being, so I've just got to see what's left for me at middleweight, and if there's nothing there, then move up. But I'm sure there will be.
There's a lot of big money fights up at super middleweight at the moment.
Yeah, there is. Yeah, and you know, obviously, I want to be in big fights. That's it. At middleweight, this is big as it gets for me. You know, Golovkin was the main man. Yeah. I was trying to beat him. Obviously, that didn't happen. So. I want to be.
How far into the fight did you notice the difference in power, like what you was taking on the gloves?
To be honest, I didn't. He hit hard, and I thought, you know, first couple of rounds, I thought, you know, he hits hard, but if I just keep on my toes there, I can just kind of like, keep nicking. I thought I won the first two rounds. The third, I thought he'd come back, and then obviously he put me down the fourth. But I could feel his power, but it wasn't really that much of his power. It was his pressure with the power. Do you know what I mean? And it was just not being able to keep him off me. But you know, I thought he had good spells, but it just wasn't good enough.